on site from the 50th Union World Health Conference on World Conference on Lung Health, and right now I am in conversation with Dr. P.S. Sarma, who is chairman of SMSL Trust, and he is a noted TB expert from the state of Andhra Pradesh, India. Andhra Pradesh is very close to Telangana, in whose cap, where in Hyderabad we are holding. Welcome, Dr. Sarma. Dr. Sarma, we are at a crossroads where we have committed to end TB by 2020 globally, and India has committed to end it by 2025. And so it is important that there are no new TB infections taking place, not only diagnose and treat the existing patients, but to prevent TB in other patients. So why do you think treating what we call the latent TB pool of Indians, many of us have latent TB, why is it important to tackle that pool, and how can that be done?
Thank you, madam. You are absolutely right. I mean, India is aiming it to stop TB by 2025, and it is very, very important. So, as rightly said, identifying latent TB cases is very much important, and definitely we should go about it, definitely.
So, how do we go about it? Like, there are not many, I think around 40 lakh more than that patients, not patients, we would say healthy people who are hiding the infection. So should we be testing everyone and treating? Household contacts of a TB patient who has active TB, should we not test them first and treat them? And what are the testing facilities available, or are there any tests available?
Madam rightly said, we need to educate people. Health awareness is very, very important. Even today, because of so much of advancement in the sciences, many people are not aware of the TB signs and symptoms. So even if they are suffering, because they are not suffering much, they are having the symptoms, neglecting, not caring about. They don't care to go to a doctor, go to a PHC or whatever it is. So the first step should be health education, number one. And the field staff should work more with commitment. That is the problem. You have a huge battalion of field staff on the government side. If they work sincerely committed with a commitment, definitely they can easily identify people having cough for more than 2 weeks, bring them to the respective hospitals nearby, get the sputum done. And also the recent advances like investigation technique like gene expert is available, and our Indian indigenously diagnosed, rather developed TrueNAT. TrueNAT is one which is a portable machine, is there, you can take anywhere. And with this help, we can easily identify them, both the regular cases and also the resistant cases also. That is the advantage. So I may just add here that, so commitment on the part of the health staff, number one. Number two, NGOs to be involved. And actually there are a good number of PPM schemes, but either I don't know whether there are many NGOs are not aware, are not utilizing these schemes, I mean rather announced by the government. So this should be the line of approach.
Okay, so you have rightly said that education is important. And involving, as has been stressed upon earlier also, that a multi-sectoral and multi-dimensional approach involving the NGOs, involving everyone in this fight, and making people aware of their status and testing them for even the latent TB infection, for which there may be no apparent symptoms, and then treating them. That is important. Okay. Thank you, Dr. Sarma. We are very happy that you were here today with us on site at the 50th Union World Conference on Lung Health, taking place in Hyderabad. Thank you.
Thank you.